Got this new guy right here, absolutely loving it. Here's a little behind the scenes of the setup. What's good, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Hope everybody's having a great day. This is going to be episode 4 of a 13-part series where I take you through every step of making an attention-grabbing nightclub aftermovie / party video. In today's episode, we're going to focus on creating an engaging story. Oftentimes, this is a lot harder than it seems. I remember having to do a lot of reshoots on my own time, or even days after the actual shoot because of this. Or you finally get a chance to look at the footage on your timeline and you're just sitting there in frustration because you have no idea how to start off the story. But that all changed when I changed my mindset entirely. I'll be talking about that today, as well as how you can create a banger introduction to your videos to make sure the user or your audience stops scrolling whatever they're doing and watches your video. In turn, getting your client the exposure they're looking for when they hired you. So jumping inside of Premiere Pro, you can see that I've color-coded the timeline into the 5 parts of the story that we're going to be focusing on today. First off, we have an attention-grabbing introduction, then we introduce the setting up phase, then we go into the build-up, the drop, and then lastly, the conclusion. Now, when you show up to an event with these 5 storytelling elements in mind, that's when the mindset shift occurs. It's only by making sure that you show up early and keeping these things in mind so you don't get too overwhelmed once you show up. If the band or the artist starts setting up at 9 p.m., make sure that you're there at 8:30. That way you can make all the important connections with the owner of the venue, with the band members themselves, and get to know them before they get too busy. And lastly, set up your own gear. Once you get all of this rolling, then you can start getting some detail shots of the band or the artist setting up. Maybe you get a little interview or some words from them themselves. But what you're primarily trying to do here is get them comfortable with you and the camera. This is gonna go a long way once the show starts. Now's your shot to get the footage of the venue getting busy. How are people spending their time? Are they playing games like in this example? It's actually funny, I didn't even set this up, but the next script in my line is there a line outside? Maybe some shots of the bartenders and then making cool drinks or doing tricks with the bottles and whatever. Are there any logos that I can capture in a cool way before the place gets too packed? And then lastly, check in with the artist again and get some more shots of them. On the flip side, let's say instead of showing up 30 minutes early, you show up an hour late. All of this, as you can imagine, becomes much harder to do. You got to get your gear ready, the band's already performing, the place is starting to get packed, and you don't have any more room to move around. This is when you start to get a little nervous because you're late and now you forget about the story, and that's when the whole video falls apart. With that being said, we're going to now focus on creating an attention-grabbing introduction that's going to stop the viewer from scrolling further into their feed. Essentially, what you want to do here is take the first 1 to 5 seconds of your video, add a lot of sound effects, make it super interesting, and include the best moments of the night super fast, in a way giving the viewer a highlight of all that happened and them wanting to see how it unfolds throughout the entire video. Let's look inside of this nested sequence and see how I was able to do that here. I picked a total of 7 clips that I thought summed up the night pretty perfectly and put them all together. We got band, everybody with their hands up, next shot, everyone with their hands up, kind of giving some continuity. Everybody looks like they're having a great time. Cowboy hats on, so it's obviously very festive. People are taking photos, people with their hands up, band going crazy. With these 7 shots here, we're trying to basically create the fear of missing out. And now that you've lured them into your video, you've grabbed their attention, you can go and start telling your story. This is gonna start with setting up. The setting up phase is characterized on the timeline by the pink and purple clips placed right here. So you can see it's actually a lot longer than the attention grabbing intro, but the setting up, the build up, and the drop are all about the same amount of time. I would say anywhere between 10 to 20 seconds long. Focusing on the setting up part of the timeline, somewhere in the midst of this, probably about 5 to 10 seconds in, I wanna try to grab the viewer's attention again since we might be losing it and we're just trying to set up the story. So let's look how I did that here. As I mentioned earlier, showing up early, about 30 minutes to an hour, so that you can get these nice shots of the logo on the drum, which is a detail I wouldn't be able to get when the venue was this crowded had I shown up an hour late, for example. But as the title of this chapter says, setting up, this is exactly what we're doing. What does the venue look like while it's getting packed? People are playing games outside, just getting these details, not only focusing on the band, having some shot variety, because just focusing on the band would get super stale and super boring. People are playing games outside, outside. We go back to the band. What are they doing? They're having a great time. Get some detail shots. It looks like the venue is getting a little more crowded. We look at everybody's faces. They're having a great time. They're thoroughly enjoying the music that the band is playing. And now we've seen what's going on in the inside. There's games. The band is playing. Everybody's enjoying the music. Let's jump to some shots that are taking place outside of the club. The place looks like it's getting packed. So what does the line look like outside? And that's what we see exactly here. A great chance to put the logo in once again, and in the foreground, putting a whole line of people, making it look like it's packed. And by not attending this, you totally missed out. Just getting towards the end of the setting up phase. My rule of thumb is to try and grab attention every 5 to 10 seconds of the video. So that's what I'm going to do right here with this transition. With this transition here, it's something different. We haven't seen photos of the night just yet. So I'm gonna include those here along with some sound effects. And if you attended, it's cool to see yourself in these photos. And then if you couldn't find them previously, well, now you know who to hit up to go and find them. Moving on from the setting up phase, we are now into the buildup phase, which is characterized by this teal slash bluish area on the timeline. We grab the viewer's attention once more right here, and the song is starting to pick up. This is a crucial part to your video because the drop is where you get to have the most fun and make the most hectic part of your video. This is where you really want to try and solidify their attention and that they're going to get to the drop. Since the music is already building up, it's doing a lot of the work for you. As the song picks up, you just make your cuts a little bit faster, editing to the beat of the song, which is going to dictate the pace of your video, including the photos there once again. Let's see how much later I actually did that. So that this is at 25 seconds, which you can see right here, keeping in mind every 5 to 10 seconds. All great shots, picking up the pace here once again. Making sure not just to edit to one instrument of the song or one beat in the entire song, but picking different things. And overall, showing really great shots, but saving the best ones for the drop, which is the section coming up. Buildup's approaching. And now we have the drop of the song. This is where we saved all of our best clips for. This section is about 15 seconds long. And since we just got them through the building up phase of the song and the video, we want to try and grab everybody's attention again. So we're going to include a shot with a lot of energy, which we haven't really seen before. A lot of camera motion, motion blur, getting really close up to the artist. We see that now we're getting super close up. Making sure to edit to the beat of the song so that we can dictate the pace and change it up so it's not getting too stale. Keeping in mind that shot variety all throughout here, not just showing the band throughout the entire drop, but also the audience and showing whether or not they're having a good time and if the people watching will want to show up to a future event that this band hosts. Cool shots with a lot of motion, that's typically my style and I always save that for the drop. You can see it's a super handheld look, a lot of switching of lenses, which we talked about in the previous video. This is on like a 24. Here we go into an 85, nice and tight detail shots, blurry background, which we didn't really get to see with that. Details of the drums that are hitting to the beat of the song. The guitar panning up to the face, and just overall high energy shots matching to the beat of the song. And since those 1 second long shots are getting kind of predictable, we start picking up the pace here, start making the cuts a lot faster. And now we're introduced to cuts that are about 1/5 of a second long, going super fast, something we haven't seen in the video just yet. And before you know it, the drop is over and we're at the conclusion of the video. This is dictated by this purplish blue section of the timeline here. So we've made it all the way to the end. You want to start slowing down the pace of your video here. Make the shots a lot longer in comparison to these 1/5 of a second long shots here. You can see that these are 47 to 50. You can see that the shots are anywhere from 2 to 3 seconds instead of 1/5 of a second, indicating that we're approaching the end of the video. And in this conclusion, it's super important that you make it evident that you've reached the end of your video. A method of how I do this is I usually cut out a portion of the song. We can check that out here. This part is about 7 frames long. We add a black video layer, which you can find in the menu right over there. drag that across, make it long. Then you drag this out, it'll originally look like this. Then what you can do is drag that out, click on it, go into effects. If you click on edit, you click on great hall and it'll add some reverb to the end of your video. That to me just sounds like way more of a finished and polished product. And then of course you add your logos to the end of the video and that's pretty much it. And boom, right there, you're gonna have every single element you'll need in order to create an engaging recap after movie or party video. We have the attention grabbing, the setting up, the build up, the drop, and the conclusion. For a 1 minute video, these are all going to be about 10 to 15 seconds. Let's say this is 15, this is 15, 15, 30, 45. Then you can split up the final 15 seconds between the conclusion and the attention grabbing introduction, and you have your video. Keeping in mind to get those important storytelling elements that are gonna set up the rest of your video in the setting up phase, and paying careful attention to pulling the viewer back into your video every 5 to 10 seconds. With that being said, I'm gonna wrap up the video here. If you guys enjoyed episode 4, make sure to check out the rest of the videos in the playlist and the next video where we talk about editing to the beat of the song, which is without a doubt my absolute favorite editing technique. I'll also be talking about where I find the music to my videos. Anyway, I'll catch you guys in the next video, Thursday, 11 a.m. AST. Peace.